Hello, Internet. Today I'm going to be connecting the Bitmain Antminer S9. This is the latest bash. We just got it last week. And I'm going to be connecting that with the Thermaltake Toughpower 1500 watts to see if it works. Let's go over the different connections and options that you can use to see how it works. Remember that each board must be connected to the same power supply. You can use two different power supplies, one power supply, or three power supplies. You just cannot mix in between the boards. You cannot use different power supplies on the same board. I'm gonna link in the description all the power supply units that you can use to power this unit. The network cable here, and it will get a DHCP address, and I'm gonna show you how to do the configuration on the browser itself. I have to advise you that this unit is very loud. It uses about 15 amps, and it just burned one of my meters to measure power because it went up 15 amps. Be careful, because most of the house circuits in US and throughout the world, they handle up to 15 amps. So you're gonna blow out a fuse, at least. If not something worse. Since you don't have an on-off button on the miner, you will have to jump your power supply so it remains on at all times. So I'm gonna follow up with a graphic of which are the pins that you need to short using a paperclip, so you can get this unit turned on just by powering on and off the power supply or the power button on the back. So let's power up the unit. The unit is really loud, so let's shoot it up and see how much noise it makes. So here's a starting. Just start is kind of quiet at the beginning, but then it's gonna get really loud as soon as the main unit kicks in. As you can see, I'm gonna show you how to configure it using different cryptocurrencies and what you can do with it. Let's switch to my screen real quick so I can show you what it is about. Once you have located the IP address for the Antminer S9, you'll be able to type that URL or that IP address into the URL bar of a web browser, and that will allow you to access the web page for the configuration of the Antminer S9. The default username and password is root. Remember that you should change this username and password in the case that you are on an external network accessible by all users that may change your miner configuration. So the first screen that you're going to be presented with is going to be the Antminer S9 system overview window, where you're going to see what is the miner type. Let me make the screen a little bit bigger here in the font to do a better use of the screen. So on the first screen, you're going to be presented with a miner type. You will see it's an Antminer S9. You can see details like the hardware version, the kernel, the file system version, the uptime since when it has been open and running. The first thing that you're gonna do, obviously, is go to administration and change the password if you need to do so. If this IP address is gonna be accessible from other networks or you're not behind a firewall, go to miner configuration, and we are going to type the different parameters that you will use for the pools. This miner, Azure miners from Bitmain, has the option to input several pool addresses, several servers. in case one of the servers just goes down, it will go to the second one or to the third. In this way, you avoid the downtime of your miner if one of the servers is not functioning properly at the time or is not reachable due to internet connectivity issues. Once you just save your general configuration, your pool details, you're going to click Save and Apply, and that's going to apply the changes to the miner. You're going to see the miner briefly reboot, the fans are going to change speed, and then you're going to browse to miner status. Once your miner status page comes back, you're going to be able to see the time that has elapsed, the gigahertz that is currently running, and how much local work is doing. And you're going to see the status of each one of the pools, if they're alive or if they're dead. Also, you're going to see the different ASIC chains. The Antminer S9 has three boards. So basically, this miner is operating properly right now. And you're going to see the chip temperature on this page. If this goes 80, then obviously you have some cooling problems. You're also going to see the different fan speeds and how they're operating at this time. Other things that you can change in the miner, you can go to network and you can assign a static IP address. In this case, this miner is connected via DHCP. It's getting an IP address from the DHCP server. You can go to the diagnostic page where you can have several network utilities that you can use to ping a host. In this case, you can ping the pool server, for example, and see if it is reachable. So as you can see, the miner gives you a response whether it was able to reach a server or not and ping it. You can do a trace route to a host. I'm using google.com, but usually, typically, you will want to do it with the pool server that you're using in your mining configuration and it's not working, you're trying to troubleshoot. The trace route completed, we're good to go. And you can go a name server lookup to make sure that your pool is being resolved properly, the name server. There you go, that's the name server. On system, you will have access to a tab, Access Administration, where you can change the password for the Antminer S9. If you click on Monitor, you're gonna see monitoring commands of the different workers that are running and the different processes that are running on the Antminer. If you go to the tab Kernel Log, it's gonna give you a log since the boot up of the system, the different voltages and the different ASIC configurations and temperatures. And if you have any errors, they're gonna show up here. On the Upgrade tab, you can back up your configuration, generate an archive here. You can reset the unit. You can restore a backup from one of the backups that you have done previously, or you can flash a new firmware into the device. Also, you will have a reboot button over here, a reboot tab, that will let you reboot the miner. That's pretty much it. This miner is running properly. All the chips are up and running and mining. In another video, I'm going to show you how to open a miner. In this case, it's going to be an Antminer L3 that came with a defective board. So you can see how to open the unit and how to get one of the chips, one of the boards out of the system, in order to send it for repairs if one of your chips became damaged. Subscribe to this channel, like this video, and I look forward to see you again on the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, subscribe to my other channels on technology, web design, general life in Los Angeles. Thank you so much for watching. I would love to see you again.